So when I call go run here, this calls out to some Go code, which then executes some C code, which in turn calls a Go function and takes the return string and then prints it using standard IO's printf. Hi, my name's Huani Bryson. If you've used Go for a while, you may have seen this import C statement. Today, we're going to look at how this statement lets us call C code from Go. First, we're going to look at some simple ways to include C in Go. Secondly, we're going to look at how we can compile some C source into Go and even call Go from that C code. And finally, we're just going to discuss some things to look out for when using C Go. So let's set up a new project. I'm going to call go mod init, and I'm going to call this tutorial slash cgo. And then I'm going to create a main.go file and give it the package name main. And now I'm going to import C. Next, I'm going to define the main function. And inside here, I'm going to call format.printf. I'm going to pass in a JSON string. So inside here, I'm going to go with pi as the key. And then for the value, I'm going to pass in a float. And then finally, I want it to pass in the C value of pi. And the way that we include C code is that we add our includes as comments. So I'm going to go include and then math.h. And if I save this and then jump into the terminal and call go run, then it prints our JSON formatted pi value from C. So basically anything that I add as comments directly above that import C statement is actually going to end up being C code that gets included in our Go project. So what I want to do next is actually print to the console from C rather than from Go. So I jump back into the main.go file, and in here I'm going to now include standard io.h, and then I'm going to define a new function, and I'm going to call this function print pi JSON, and then add some brackets, and we need to add these comments here. And now, because we've included standard IO, I can just call printf, and I'm going to pass the same string down here because the formatting is the same, but I'm going to now include mpy without needing that C. I'm going to jump down into the main function, and I'm going to replace this with print pi JSON. And don't forget, this is C code, so we actually need a semicolon at the end of this printf here. The other thing to remember is that we should have C dot here, because we're calling it from the C package. So if we save this, jump back into the terminal and call go run, and it prints the same result, but this time the printing and the formatting are all coming from C. Personally, I find coding C in comments a bit unsettling, so we're going to move these into their own C files. We'll start by copying this code here, and then we'll create a new file, and I'm going to call this printer.c, and in here we'll just paste that code and uncomment this. And I want to create a printer.h file, but before that, I'm also going to include that file here just by going include printer.h. And we can save this file, maybe format it a little bit better. And then I'm going to jump back into the terminal and I'm going to create printer.h. The first thing we want to do is add our header guards. And all we're going to do inside this header file is define our printpyJSON function. So now we have some C source, which we can call from our Go file. So inside the Go file, we can remove all of this, except we'll leave one include printer.h. And if we save this, we can call go run from the terminal, and we still get the same JSON formatted string, but this time it's compiling from those C source files. Another cool thing that cgo lets us do is call go code from C. In this case, I want C to be able to take advantage of Go's inbuilt JSON marshalling. So we'll jump back into the code, and here I want to define a new function, and I'm going to call this encode f64. And for its first argument, it's going to take a key, and this is going to be of type C, pointer to a C char. And then the second input is going to be a value, which will be a float 64. It's going to return a pointer to a C char, which we'll see later on is actually going to result in a memory leak, which we definitely don't want to be doing, but I'm just going to keep it simple for the sake of this example. So I'm going to go m is equal to map of strings, and for the values, they're going to be float 64. Inside this map, we can go c.goString and then pass the key into there, and then we can just pass the value in as normal. The next thing we want to do is use our JSON library to convert that into bytes. I'm going to ignore the error here and just go JSON marshal, and I'm going to pass the address of the map in here. Now I'm going to add a comment that says, warning, this is a memory leak. because I really want to hammer it home that we should not be doing this normally. But what we are going to do here is we're going to return a call to c.c string, and we're going to pass in our bytes here converted into a string. Now normally when we do this, we'd want to defer some kind of cleanup for this memory. In this case, I'm just keeping this code super simple for this example. But please don't do this in your production code, because this memory here is never going to get deallocated. Now we want encode F64 to be callable from C, so to do that, we're going to add a comment which says export encode F64. Now if we jump into printer.c, we want to include cgo export.h, which is going to include everything that has that export tag. And inside our printpy.json, instead of including this formatted string, I'm just going to simplify this right down to just a string. And in here is where we're going to call our exported function. So we're going to go encode F64. And now we get to pass in a key and a value. The key will be the string pi, and the value will be m_pi. And if we jump back in the terminal and call go run, we once again printing a JSON string with pi in it. Although pi is a little bit longer here, and that's because the JSON marshaller is formatting pi to represent float 64 precision. I just want to discuss a few gotchas with using cgo in your project. Unfortunately, when you start using cgo, you lose the ability to easily cross-compile between different machines on your project. The reason for this is that cgo uses the C compiler on your machine. So if you don't have the C compiler set up with Go for different architectures and different machines, then it's not going to be able to compile that C code. Another thing that gets a little bit harder with cgo is debugging. Unfortunately, once the program counter goes into C code, it doesn't really know how to behave properly. We also need to be really careful with memory safety. C doesn't garbage collect, and Go is not going to garbage collect your C pointers. But when you allocate C pointers in Go, make sure that you clean them up with a statement like this. My parting advice is to keep your interfaces between Go and C simple and clean. I've been Hwani Bryson, happy coding, and I'll see you later.